Did you know that there are some very special tarantulas out there who don't really look like the ones you got back at home? Let's find out. Welcome to a new episode on this channel. It's Tuesday. That means we're going to cover some scientific talk and hobby stuff talk. So therefore, I would like to introduce you to some very unique tarantula. But before we start, I will say a huge thank you to all of you. It was like 6 months ago where we started this whole series here on YouTube. And we've been from like zero to over 1,000 subscribers. It's just insane. The watch hour, like the people who watch the videos, it's like over 4,000 hours watch time. That means that there's so many people out there watching these videos. Awesome. Couldn't be happier. And yeah, that's the point where we just start into the video. So regarding this specific tarantula, it is somewhat special because it is not available in the hobby, in the pet trade. And it is only known from dead material, already dead specimens who were collected. So no live images, but there are extremely nice pictures of it in the scientific redescription, and that's the one we're going to cover now. So the title of the paper we're going to cover right now is On the Placement of Four Phoneyusa Species, and the authors are Richard Gallen from Great Britain and the arachnologist Ingo Wendt from Germany. And they both wrote on this paper, worked on this paper in 2015, it got published, and they cover, as the title suggests, four species and the new placement of them. But there is a single species which is outstanding, fascinating specimen. And this is the specimen of the now called Hysterocrates elephantiasis. And the species name elephantiasis refers to something they might have in common with an elephant. So we'll just cover this one right now and have a look at the pictures. So what you're also able to see at the very beginning of the paper is that Richard Gallen is still working on these African tarantulas, and there is something already in preparation which he will come in the near future, I think. So, yeah, the genus Hysterocrates and Phoneyusa, for example, they're still, getting work done there, and hopefully there will be some publication in the near future. So, regarding this Hysterocrates elephantiasis species, it now is within a new combination, so they transferred it from the genus Phoneyusa into Hysterocrates, but the very interesting part is that there is just one specimen known. The type material is just a single female specimen collected, quite a long time ago. And this is actually one of the first pictures, or even the first picture publicly available, and just outstanding. What they differ though from other tarantulas in the subfamily is that they have a different keel on the bulbus, so I can maybe show a little picture later on. But that's just the tables where they did all the measurements in, and now these are the pictures of the specimen, and you can see on the top and bottom left, now just zooming in, awesome specimen. These extremely thick legs on the first pair of leg, it is outstanding. Something I've never seen before. Most likely you guys have never seen it before either. Fascinating specimen, fascinating species. To my knowledge, there is no other species of tarantulas who has this kind of incrassate legs in the first pair of leg. There are some species who have it on the fourth pair of leg, for example the very same one, Pelinobius muticus from Africa as well. So it's just like a reversed king baboon spider, and I'm not sure if this one really gets available or documented more. Do they fight over the title King Baboon Spiders with the Pelinobius Multicus? I don't know. So here again, a drawing of the leg one with these, yeah, just insanely thick leg one. Awesome. And that basically is the whole thing behind this species. It is not known to the hobby. Actually, the specimens here are quite old. So have you seen in the earlier pictures, they're from 1903, I think. This species hasn't been seen over 100 years in live specimens. So if someone is brave enough from you guys to go to Congo, feel free to go and make sure you take some pictures of the live elephantiasis species. That would be amazing for sure. Ecology, completely unknown, of course. They think it's fossorial tarantula, which totally makes sense, but they just simply don't know. As I said, there is no live record of this elephantiasis species. Yeah, that was it. The whole map distribution, you can see where the other Phoneyusa, or now Hysterocrates, species occur in. And these star symbols are the elephantiasis records. So we have the holotype, which is a female specimen, and then now they also have male specimens. So this, yeah, species is now illustrated and documented in both genders, which is just really nice to have. So at the moment, Brazil, or the scientists in Brazil, are facing a huge crisis. Actually, one of the most important museums and the oldest natural history museum in Rio de Janeiro burned down completely, almost completely. They were able to like save a few jars or a few, yeah, things they are preserving there, but sadly the vast majority of things and important material got destroyed. So they of course had a very, very important neotropical spider arachne collection there, and this is all gone now. But of course there are like, yeah, in somewhat even more important natural history data to the mankind known, which is gone forever as well. So this is why I made a short Facebook post. I know it doesn't do much, but we from birdspidersCH are now like collecting all the material from Brazil tarantula spiders, and we are still working on this, but as soon as we have enough material and they start rebuilding their collection, we would like to like donate the vast majority or even all of the Brazil tarantula specimens we have in collection for like science purposes, so they can rebuild their hopefully natural history data again. So yeah, that was it from the Tuesday video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Hit the like button if you liked the video, and of course stay tuned for Friday when we have another Tarantula in the Wild video, which we are going to upload, and we will reveal the location we are heading to, and hopefully you'll enjoy it. So enjoy your evening and see you soon.